Hey everyone, welcome back to the part 3 of our realistic portrait drawing series featuring Rohit Sharma. In this video, we will dive into the fine details of his forehead, left eye and cheek, focusing on capturing those unique texture and subtle facial expression that make his portrait come to life. We will pay special attention to the intricate shading, highlights and the natural lines that give his face character. So grab your materials and let's get started. For this tutorial, you will need a range of graphite and charcoal supplies, including HB, 2B and 4B pencil, soft charcoal pencil, graphite powder, charcoal powder, a variety of brushes and some eraser for detailing. Let's begin with the forehead. This area has subtle but essential texture and lightning pattern that we need to capture accurately for the realistic look. Rohit has a naturally uneven skin texture on his forehead, which we will emphasize through light shading and careful blending. I will start by applying a base layer to establish the overall tones using HB graphite powder. As you apply it, remember to use circular motion with your brush for smooth even layer that mimics the natural surface of the skin. Once the base is set, we will focus on creating the small hair patches on the left side of his forehead. Use a sharp, soft charcoal pencil to make thin, small strokes that resembles the short hair naturally scattered across the area. These tiny details add a touch of realism. Next, dip your brush in 2B graphite powder and start adding midtones around the curved areas of his forehead. This will help to give depth and three-dimensional appearance to the portrait, making the forehead look more lifelike. I am also using my HB pencil in some areas to draw the fine wrinkles on the forehead. This will add a bit more texture and highlight his expressions. Then use a sharp charcoal pencil to carefully draw individual hair coming down onto the forehead, which adds to the overall realistic effect. For the darkest shadows, dip a medium-sized brush in charcoal powder and apply it to the deeper curves and creases of the forehead. Be mindful on the natural shading variation on the forehead, and use both graphite and charcoal in layers, adjusting the intensity according to the darkness of each area. Now moving on to adding highlights. For precise control in small areas, use a fine tip pencil eraser. Carefully tap and swipe the eraser across areas where you want to bring out the brightest highlights. This technique will emphasize the contours of his face and add a natural glow. For softer and more diffused highlights, switch to kneadable eraser. Simply knead it into a point or shape that works best in your area, and gently tap on the spots where you want a soft, gentle highlight. This approach is perfect for creating subtle glow, particularly in areas where the light is softer. While adding highlights, I am also smudging the surrounding shades using blending stump. This blending not only helps transition from light to dark smoothly, but also contributes to realistic texture of the skin. By softening the areas around the highlights, we enhance the natural look, making the highlights appear even more luminous and lifelike.
Going to
After completing the shading on the forehead, let's shift focus to shading the eye, a critical element in any portrait, as it often becomes a focal point that draws the viewer in. Capturing the details accurately is essential for realism. Begin by carefully refining the outlines around the eye. For shading the iris, use a soft charcoal pencil. Start by darkening the pupil, making sure to keep it intense and clean. Then use slight circular strokes around the iris to create subtle texture. Leave a small highlight in the pupil to achieve that natural sparkle effect, which brings life to the eye. Next, add a dark fine line along the upper eyelid to suggest depth and shadow. This shadow can be extended to emphasize the eye's form, creating a sense of three-dimensionality. Below the eye, add soft gradual shadow to depict any slight hollows or folds, using layers of graphite and charcoal. Observe the reference image closely to replicate the appropriate darkness levels for each area. Once the eye's basic structure is established, move on to the eyebrows. Take a well-sharpened charcoal pencil and follow the initial strokes you have laid down to represent individual eyebrow hair. After creating the base layer, blend the strokes lightly using a small brush to adding volume to the eyebrow hair. Repeat the layering process to increase density as needed. With a mono-zero eraser, carefully add highlights to the eyebrow, focusing on areas where light would naturally reflect. As a final step, refine the shading around the eye to deepen the areas that receive less light, enhancing the realism and depth. Draw any additional features such as eyelashes with delicate strokes, ensuring they follow the natural curve of the eyelid. Use a range of erasers from broad to fine-tipped to add highlights to the eye itself and the surrounding skin textures. This careful contrast between light and dark areas will help to achieve lifelike appearance. Now that we have completed the eye, let's move on to shading the left cheek. Begin by applying a base shade across the cheek, keeping the left portion unshaded, as it catches more light and will become a prominent highlight. Reserving this lighter area will help to create strong contrast, making the highlight stand out once the shading is complete. Right along the edge of the highlight, add a deeper shadow to emphasize this contrast, which will make the cheek appear more three-dimensional. For this shadow, start by using 2B graphite powder to build up the darkness gradually. Later you can layer in a bit of charcoal to enhance the depth and increase the richness of the contrast. Move on to add midtones across the cheek, concentrating on the areas that curves naturally away from the light source. This will help to create smooth gradients that mimics the contours of the face. To add a realistic skin texture, lightly dab the cheek area with the kneaded eraser to create small, irregular light spots that resembles natural pores. You can also use your blending stump to add subtle dotted patterns around the highlights, enhancing the skin texture and realism. After establishing the midtones and textures, revisit the shadow beside the highlight and darken it if necessary to maintain the clear contrast. Lightly touch up any skin texture that may have softened or faded during the blending process, as these tiny details add the lifelike appearance of the portrait. And that's it for the tutorial. We have successfully shaded the forehead, left eye and left cheek, covering techniques for highlights, shadows and texture. Remember it, these small details and texture that truly bring a portrait to life. I hope you enjoyed this segment and found it helpful for developing your own skills. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more.